And so our friend Artin said that he's starting college today, and so it made me think of my college days and any tips that I could think of that could possibly help him out when he's going to college or when he's at his college classes. I know a lot of colleges are going online only right now, so these tips will be applicable when you are back in actual classrooms. And I guess you can even do some of these tips from Zoom and from wherever you're doing things online. You know, you could do some of these things that way. If you've already been to college, that's totally fine. Thanks for watching the video and clicking on it. I appreciate your support. Leave some comments down below telling your own tips to anybody that is going into college soon. I have this idea about making videos and giving advice to people as they go through different stages of life. So for example, Artin said he's going to college, and so I wanna, you know, give my own advice and give some college tips to help him out, because I want him to be successful, get those straight A's, and come out of college with a nice big old degree you can hang on your wall that hopefully doesn't cost you about $200,000. So I thought, how cool would it be if we could give him some advice and tell him what he needs to do to succeed? When I was a freshman in college, I was scared out of my mind. I didn't know what to expect. And so let's help him out. Everybody, if you've been to college, share your comments down below. What would you tell somebody that may or may not be nervous about doing college or starting college? I can't guarantee it'll all be good advice, but we'll definitely have some thoughts. You have to decide for yourself whether you take all the advice that you're gonna see in the comments down below. That's for you to decide. You may have to go digging. You may have to find the needle in the haystack, but you'll find something good down there. I've seen the advice that we've left in the Discord, and I'm curious to see how that's gonna go. And I'll also be telling you about the only time in my life when I got an F. That's right, it was in college. I told the professor. I told the professor that I disagreed with her, and she gave me a big fat F. Let's get into the tips real quick in case anybody out there is in high school. This goes for high schoolers as well, or college students. Either way, let's start the show. You want the teacher to get used to you just raising your hand every single class. That way you can get the full participation points, and you want to be able to actually answer a question. And the longer you wait in the class, the tougher the questions usually get. Teachers usually start with easier questions and then they go to the hard ones. So why don't you just like raise your hand, get those participation points at the beginning, and answer those easy questions. The second thing I would recommend is sitting in the front or in the front two rows of the class. If the teacher sees you sitting in the front, then they will like you more because they're gonna think, oh, this person's more engaged in the class. So if they see you in the front of the class and they see you raising your hand once every class, man, you're golden. The teacher's gonna love you and they're gonna wanna help you out more than hurt you. And not really teacher, I guess it's a professor now. Teacher in high school, professor in college. If the professor has office hours, I would recommend going at least once or twice to their office hours early in the semester. You want to do this early on because you want them to know your name and know your face, and you want them to be like, oh, this person came and visited me. Whether you're going to visit them a bunch throughout the semester doesn't really matter, but if you visit them like twice in the first 2 weeks, it'll get you on a good path, and the first impression is always the most important. And so doing these things right from the start will put you on the good side for the professor, and it's not like you're a teacher's pet, okay? Once you get to college, the idea of a teacher's pet just goes out the window. No one cares anymore. You're gonna have people that want to get good grades, and then you're gonna have people that really don't care. This next tip has nothing to do with the classes. It has everything to do with you having a good college experience wherever you go, and that is within the first month, go and say hi to people in your classes or on your dorm floor. Even if you're the shyest person ever, just make an effort to like say hi to the other people in your class. Because within the first month, everybody is like forming their friend groups, and after that, it's really hard because everybody has their friend groups already, and if you don't do that, then it might be a little bit awkward. If you're gonna live at a college, then go and say hello to everybody on your floor. Get to know them all within the first month. The thing is, everybody is feeling awkward. Everyone is like feeling out of place, especially if you're a freshman. This is totally true. Everybody is nervous about everybody else. Very few people are natural extroverts and just don't care about what anyone thinks. But if you go and say hi to somebody, it'll make them feel better and they will like you more. and you're on your way to having some beautiful friendships. This next tip is something that I never really thought about much, and it is the importance of homework. Usually, the professor or the teacher will give you a syllabus at the beginning of the semester and say, this is how much your tests are worth for your overall grade, and this is how much your homework is worth for your overall grade, and oh yeah, this is participation, this is how much that's worth. Usually the homework comes out to being like 25% of the grade. You add up your homework portion and the participation portion, and usually that is like 35 to 40% of your entire grade. And so I would be in college, and people would be, you know, not doing their homework, and I'm like, are you stupid? This is like one of the most important things. And you know, I was always good at taking tests. I always got decent grades, A's and B's. But if you are not the best test taker and you don't really get the best test grades, well then you need something else to prop up your grade. And that is the point of the homework. So like, I would from the start, from the first week, make sure you're at least on top of your homework and getting those homework grades, because you wanna make sure you don't set yourself up for failure. You can ace every single test and not pass in any of your homework, which I know people who did this. My freshman roommate in college did this, and he still ended up getting C's on his grades. He would pass all the tests, wouldn't do the homework, no participation, wouldn't show up, and he gets C's. He recently added me on Facebook too, like out of nowhere. I sent him a friend request back when we just first met each other on Facebook back in 2010. Like the school paired us up, and I found him on Facebook in 2010, and that was when I went to college as a freshman, and I'm like, oh, I gotta add him. I wanna message him and add him. And so I added him, and he just yesterday added me on Facebook. Like it's been 10 years, Greg. 10 years, and you're now friending me on Facebook. I'm glad I'm your friend now. I'm glad we were able to bypass our differences. And how could I forget my story, my one and only F in my life? This was the most awkward situation I've ever had with a teacher. So after I graduated college, I decided to go back to start my master's degree. I was paying $1,000 per class. Class was about education. That's what it was called. It was education for future math teachers. And the teacher told me, she said, Chris, you have to like Common Core. You have to, you no other choice, you have to like Common Core. You have to like it, Chris. You have to. And I'm only partially joking about how she said that. And then all of a sudden she comes into class and she starts talking about Common Core math. Now, I'm not sure if you're familiar with Common Core math, so let me give you a quick example of something that they would do. If I had to ask you what 12 times 12 is, to get 12 times 12, they would do 12 times 10 is 120, plus 12 times 2 is 24. So 120 plus 24 is equal to 144. That is Common Core math. They try to break it down so you can think of things differently. Now, I understand using that sometimes, and I understand how that could be helpful sometimes, but when it comes to multiplication, I am a big fan of just learning your multiplication tables. I don't think you have to break things down like this, and as I would learn more about Common Core, I'm like, I don't like how they're teaching that. I like a more definitive answer. I don't want an answer that could, you know, oh, it could be this or it could be this, depending on how you look at this. No, math has a very specific answer. Science has a very specific answer. And she started telling me like, oh, you can ask questions and not have a specific answer. It matters more about how they do their work and the process of getting to the right answer than actually getting the right answer. So if I was teaching a class and I said 5 times 2 equals blank and a kid wrote down the number 8 with an explanation of how he got the number 8, I might have to give him credit. If you are building a rocket ship for Elon Musk, you gotta have the right answer. You gotta do it. There's no option other than to have the right answer to all your sequences. And so I didn't like that. I told the teacher, no, I don't agree with this. I don't think this is the best way to do this. Now, there were 3 other kids in the class. None of them said anything, but one other kid agreed with me. He just didn't say anything during the class because he didn't want confrontation. And so I got into like an argument with the teacher in class saying, no, I don't think this is good. I do not think this is good. And I have have the right to have my own opinion on Common Core. So no, I don't agree with you. I don't think this is good. And I'm telling you, I did all the work. I did every single piece of homework. I did every single assignment. I participated in every single class. I talked to her after class to let her know I cared. And she gave me an F. It's one of these situations where if you don't agree with the professor, they are going to fail you. Now, after this happened, I went to her manager. I went to the head of the department, so I decided I'm gonna be a Karen and go to the manager. And you know what they did? They assigned me my own private teacher. And that teacher talked through everything that the other professor taught me, but better. And that teacher agreed with me on Common Core. That teacher said, yes, yeah, I agree with you. It's a lot of the things are not good. A lot of it's not, okay, Chris? But you gotta do this to get the grade. You gotta do some of these things to get the grade. This is the last tip. If you're in college, sometimes you'll have to bite your tongue. You will get a teacher that you disagree with, and it will take everything inside you to not stand up and just be like, no. Like, you are paying so much money to go to this college. It is ridiculous. You should not be paying this much, but of course, I paid too much too. I paid way too much, and I didn't realize how much I was paying per class. When you break it down, you divide the numbers, you look at, oh my gosh, I'm paying like $150, $300 a class. The point being, be very careful about which battles you pick with your professors. I want you to get the best grade that you can. And unfortunately, the professors can and will and have flunked people because they have students that disagree. And I am a living testimony to that. And I don't want that to happen to you. I want you to get your money's worth and have an amazing college experience. And you know what? I think that is gonna do it for today's video of Tips with Chris. Hey, thanks so much for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button down below, smash the subscribe button down below. That way you never miss another one of my videos. Let me know in the comments, are there any other tips for high schoolers and or college students that you would give to somebody to help them succeed at college? Let me know. Read the comments if you're watching this for those tips, because I know a lot of my people in my community are going off to college soon or have already been at college, so we can hook you up with the good, best tips. And guys, be sure to grab your headphones and grab a drink, because it's time to make a video.